Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar. Blind, I'm the RPG chick, Amethyst Lunatari. What are we doing back here in Twinlake? Right? When I left off last episode, I said we were going to go down to level 2 of Orlando's wine cellar and see what lurks down there. But I realized I can level up Silk 2 levels. I can level up Drobaneer. I can also go here to, Chandra's house, which we're in front of. And I can also get Trazric some more sling stones. So, how about we do that? I'll be completely ready because, as usually is the case, when you go down a level in a dungeon, things get tougher. So, Chandra, as I mentioned, I think, last episode, he will give you potions. He will fill your potions in exchange for, the empty flasks. He just doesn't have the flasks, in other words, so... Let's see what we can get. I'm not sure what kind of potions we can get. And I'm not sure where he is, either. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Well, it's 10 p.m. The old guy's still not in bed. Oh, he's in his chair. I wonder if I breezed right by him. Now, I don't think he has anything new to say. Quest. Yeah, you said that before. EM Army, etc. Turbos. Right. Now you ask him potions, which is not in here, so. You would like a potion? No problem. I am well known throughout the country for my skill at making potions, but unfortunately I have no empty flasks at the moment with which I can use for the potion. Do you have one with you? See, we do. I have silk. Give. Yes. Chandra takes the flask from you and briefly disappears into his laboratory. When he returns, the flask contains a blue liquid. Here is your potion. If you need any more, you must find me more flasks. Well, we have plenty. Okay. I think this is the high-level healing spell. Not completely sure. Okay, that's good. Now, do I have to ask him again, or just give him stuff? Okay, good. Can I just keep going like this? Evidently so. Nice. Getting all these potions. Now who else has them? Gribben has one. And Drobaneer has one. Sweet. Oh. Didn't mean to do that. To give to us. Okay, so now we have Amethyst has 4 of those. Silk has one. Graban has one. Tragic has one. And Jomineer has one. Yay. Awesome stuff. So, we are done. How do we get the hell out of here? Don't be following us now. Give us those potions fair and square. Excuse me, guys. So, I hate when it flips us like that. It's because the leftover mouse clicks from when I was leaving the place. So we are... just trying to see where else we want to go. I think... the Guild of Warriors is right here. Oh, I don't think he's gonna go up. That's right. He still needs 113 experience. Sorry, guys. Thought about that. It's everyone else that levels up except for him. Okay, we still need to hit the Thieves Guild then for Silk, which is at the Dancing Dragon. The Merchant is very nearby, so we'll go in there next. We need more Sling Stones for our magic user here, our Tragic. Oh geez, it's late. Oh, it's midnight. I guess the Warriors Guild is open at any time. What time do they open? 9 a.m. We'll just stand here in front of the doorway and block everyone from entering and exiting. Because that's the way we roll. Shot my mark a little. How much do we need? Do we need anything else here? We have torches, we have... unless we want to give Droba a round shield. Certainly within our grasp, isn't it? I don't remember seeing a round shield there. Oh, we can't even use it. Then we'd give it to Griban. Damage 2, shield 2. Should have could have looked at it right here. No damage, but shield 5. I think we'll take that. No, I do not. Actually, I might come back here. I have to... well... yeah, we have to pass near here to leave anyway. I want to make sure I can level up Silk all the levels that he needs. So, since we're here anyway, let's just buy... ...31 Sling Stones. Oops. ...50 is like the sweet spot for me anyway. Good thing it reminds me. Otherwise, I'd end up leaving all my gold there. Okay, so he's got 50, and he really can't carry much more. It's okay. So we are here. We want to go to Oh, we're at the merchant, right? A 9 is the sage. Yeah, we're gonna be cheesy at the sage. Sorry, guys. on the same... Okay, we wanna go this way then. I think. Just check where we are. The sage is... Where's the sage? I think we wanted to head down this way. The sage is here. Well, we just need to make a right. We can go over there anyway. From here. We're gonna save scum and identify items. We're at... Is this the dancing dragon? Yes. You know what? Yeah. Let's level up Silk. Because identifying items costs money, even if I'm restoring stuff. I'm completely sure where this room is. Between two fireplaces or something. Two chimneys, rather. And those were not chimneys. I think it's not in this area. Taking a load off for a second. I think it's something completely different. I get so confused with this sometimes. I don't know why. I don't know what my major malfunction is. I think we want to go through the kitchen then. I'm not sure. Hang on. He needs an item. I have no idea where to find it. This is a dead end. Alright. I think it would be... You know, it's down a small, narrow hallway, isn't it? Like this. Okay, so there's two chimneys. Boom. $350 gold. Okay. You know what I'm gonna do? I am gonna make attack 20 and parry 10. Other than that, find traps, detect traps, pick locks. Maximum hit points is now 28. We can train him again. I'm gonna leave these as is. Increase all this crap. Equally. I guess listening would be important sometimes. Maximum LP is now 40. 93 experience, that's it for the next level. Hooray! So since we've accomplished some stuff, let's save. Oh, A cat told us where to find this, guys. And you know, it's not that far off, either. I was looking all over the freaking place. Alright. Now, unfortunately, Silk looks so low on hit points. Because this is his old maximum. Now he's 40. Get out of my damn way. Pardon my French, guys. So, alright, we've done that. What else do we need to see? The Sage of Twinlake. Do we need rations? I don't think so. We found a lot. 8, 30, 12, 11, 15, and 15. Yeah, we do not need a ration store. We found so many off those goblins. Merchant of Twinlake, I guess we can make our way back there, but first, Guild of Warriors, we need to identify items at the Sage. Chandra, done. Yeah, identify items. We're at 10, we need to be at 9, which is right around the corner. Okay, so we're looking at it. We want to head right. And make a left. Oh no, that's the stables. The hell? Stables are 11. This way. Knowledge is power, so use my services. Now, it's Gridman who has this stuff. You know what? Does Silk have room? Silk is better at prices. I want to see why he's better at prices. It's probably his strength, intelligence, dex. Speed, con, charisma, luck? I don't know. Attack, parry, swimming, listening, search. Yeah, what makes him better? I guess intelligence? Dexter? Oh, charisma. This is charisma. He has 60 out of 60 con. 34 doesn't cut it. Neither does 39. 14 is horrible. He gets the worst prices, I noticed. And 32. So, yeah. Silk has, like, perfect charisma, at least for a human being. Or a bipedal entity. So, Silk it is for our stuff. Let's exit out of here. So I'm gonna give these stuff. Sphere of Opening. See, we already know what this stuff is. Old Ring, Old Iron Ring. I have a feeling some of this stuff is identifiable. Just, I mean, probably one of them is, and the rest is just whatever. I wonder if he would identify the potions. And the Sphere of Opening. I'm not trying to use it. Probably not. Alright, so now that he's got this stuff, let me save. Oh god, while I was doing that, we just missed the 4 p.m. I believe window for him to be open. Damn it. He opens at 12 noon. Oh my god, these banker's hours here. So, I know there's a possibility for us to come across, actually there are cursed items in the game, so at one point we'll come across them. That's why I didn't want to just put stuff on. Excuse me. Rings make me nervous. As well as brooches, necklaces, bracelets, stuff like that. 12 noon, my god. Sages are lazy. He's busy reading books or something. I don't know. And sleeping. And then we gotta head back to the merchant, and then we're done. Welcome, adventurers. Should I check some items for you? Yes, you should. Actually, I'm gonna save again. Why doesn't this stuff show up? Oh, because... What does this stuff do? Okay. It switches between, I guess, treasure and non-treasure? I don't even know. Oh, this means everything? I'm so confused. My price for testing is 250 gold. Okay. I'm gonna cheat here. We find out what the big M things are, if he identifies it. Actually, we go like this. Make this easier. 250 gold. Potion. Okay, I was right. It's a healing potion. Equivalent, I guess, to a level 5 healing spell. LP max, I don't even know what this stuff means. This isn't stuff I can like click on, no. Okay, so now we know what that is. That's what I thought it was. $250 gold. Sphere of opening. Say anything. What a ripoff. I do want to get up to those things, but yeah, nothing much. Okay, so we know what that is then. This... gives you back magic. Okay. So it kind of looks like, I don't know, like a Black Widow or an Infinity symbol, a stylized Infinity symbol or something like that. Gives you back your spell points. I think this is like an anti-venom. Neutralize poison. Anti-poison. Got it. Does she have anything else? What if we identify the Amberstar? He'll identify anything, this guy. Piece of Amberstar. I'm just curious if it says anything. Which it does not. Neutralize poison. Where's her other piece of the Amber Star, actually? I don't tell you that, right? I'm nervous now. No. Yeah, I'm not that generous. At least not on purpose. Okay, two. We have two. Other pieces of the Amberstar stack. Good to see. Alright. Let's identify other stuff. Actually, all I have to do is go like this. Alright. Old ring. Fingers one. 35 grams. Apparently this is nothing. Just an old ring. Gold brooch. Cursed. Look at that. It's a cursed item. Strength minus 5. That's sucky. And what about the iron ring? Fingers. Oh! Shield 1. So it gives you 1 to your AC. Okay, the old ring. I don't know. The old ring. What did the guy. What did the chef say he wanted in the Dancing Dragon? Did he say he was looking for a ring? I forgot what he said he was missing. So you know what we're gonna do? I know this might seem strange to you guys, but what I'm gonna do... I'm going to identify the brooch fair and square to find out it's cursed. Makes sense for in-game purposes. And we're going to identify the iron ring to know that it gives you plus 1 shield. I know I just wasted 500 gold, but for in-game purposes. Sort of semi-role-playing, right? Now, do we remember this stuff? We do. See that? Did we know it was Shield 1 when we looked at it? I might not even realize at that time. You know what we're gonna do then? I'm not gonna use it. We're gonna give it to Amethyst, and she's a magic user, has sucky AC, stuff like that. Plus, she's not even a magic user yet. He has 6. She has 5. So she's gonna be equal to him, actually. The Trazric. Which is sad. How did she get equal to him? Maybe I put something in here. Oh, you know, I might have had dexterity up high enough to where she got a bonus. Because his is only 32. Speed might play a factor as well. Well, his is higher. I don't know. All in all, I want myself to have, you know. So we have to go back to the Dancing Dragon anyway to get Silk up to full again. So I just wandered out of there. I am at the Sage, so I'm facing the Sage I need to hit this. Spending more money at these places. Just so Silk can get 24 hit points. Hooray. Alright, let's see what that chef wanted, because we might... If it's the ring, then we have that. Be a quest fulfilled. One of these people here. Barmaid. Problem? No, or quest. Oh, I think it was quest. I lost my old ring. A few weeks ago, I lost my old ring. It fell through a gap in the drain cover, and I couldn't find it. If you bring the ring back to me, you can have the crystal ball. Okay, just in case, we give him this, and he keeps it, and it's not the ring he wants. I'm very careful with little games like this. Ask him about ring. Ring. You know, I think I had the ring when I talked to him too. Guys are probably yelling at the screen. Alright. So we give old ring. Many thanks for your help. Here is the crystal ball. Perhaps it will be useful to you. Sweet crystal ball. Just give it to me. Nice. Anything else to say? Sometimes they have extra dialogue. I like to pump them. As much dialogue out of these people as possible. Hello, my friends. How have you been? Sit down and have a bowl of soup with me. Mmm, soup. So you're opening a crystal ball. Magic item. I guess now back to the sage. Unless it's one of those special things that you use. I don't know. What? Are you serious? That's awesome. So it tells you where you are. Inside anywhere? Or just these structures? That's awesome. All What if it shows you... Of course, we don't have our torch on, so I'm wondering the limits of this thing. Oh, look at that. Now, would it still show us all this if we hadn't already mapped it out? That's a question. Nice. Look at that, a map of the entire city like that. That's awesome. Ha ha ha. You know, I'm wondering though. I wonder if this thing has unlimited uses, because you see, when you press it, it sparkles like the torches, and the torches disappear. I'm like kind of wondering silently to myself if the thing's gonna disappear. Oh! That's not good. We did that way too many times, didn't we? So it's not that the thing disappears, it's that we get a stack overflow in the Amiga operating system. It's not even a guru meditation error. That'll probably be even worse. Press any key to continue. Oh! Ta-da! Software failure. Okay. Oh my. Okay. Alright, in any case, I'm not gonna use this unless I really need to, in case it randomly disappears or it has a certain amount of charges. Could be really handy for one. I mean, you could always use the map, right? But I guess if you're in a place like this, so that's neat. We completed a quest. Did you guys hear the disc running in the background? I hear something underneath the music. Alright, we're facing the dancing dragon. I do, you hear it? Ha ha ha. I hope it's not too bothersome. I want to see what he says. I don't think there's going to be anything that useful. Actually, he's closed. And I think that's all I have to do, right? Merchant. Oh, back to the merchant to get a better shield. I don't suppose we got experience. Have you ever been experienced? Yeah, Joba needs 840, so... yeah, we're not leveling him up this episode. Unfortunately. Yeah, that is funny, but you know, once I save the game and reload, it's... or save the state and reload, it should stop, I hope. I'm just gonna save here anyway. So we can leave during the day. What? I do have gold, thank you very much. Not keeping this, by the way. Magic item, 2500 grams. Map show. That's interesting. Map show 80. Is that an actual spell? Was that like a special effect? I don't know if that's an actual spell you can cast. I doubt it because it's level 80. Map show. I think it's a special thing. That's why I like to do stuff like this. I don't know. It's interesting. To me, anyway. Okay, back to the merchant, and then we're done in Twinlake again. And then we'll head back for Crystal. The merchant is... alright, we head this way. And... yeah, basically, as long as he followed this right wall, we will get there. Look at that, we're kind of broke. Well, not broke, but, you know. We've definitely had more money than this. We've had about twice more money than this. Oh, right, silk to buy stuff. You know, will he buy any of this stuff? The brooch. Okay, it's cursed. Have fun with it. The iron ring we're keeping, and the old ring we gave away. Cool. Alright. Those are the three things we found in the sewer. That was a pretty awesome sewer with those rats. It was exciting. Never had such a fun time killing rats, I don't think. The cranium rats in Planescape Torment were not so much fun as extremely dangerous, especially in that one dungeon where you found so many of them. My god, they were swarming all over the place and throwing lightning at me and stuff. Not fun. They were throwing lightning with their mind. Anyway, we want to convert gold into an item. A round shield. 940 gold. Might as well. And give to Griban. So he's got, wow, he's pretty good. Defense 19. What's his parry skill, actually? Now 22. Sweet. He's a beast now, too. Look at that, 80 hit points. Jobanier 108. Nice. Okay, so now we can sell the buckler. My apologies for the disc sound. $90. Get back some of it. How much gold do I have? The easy way to see. Broke. 754. We'll find more. that we are much better prepared for what awaits us at the second level of Orlando's wine cellar. So we are... we're facing it. So we want to turn around. No, that's a dead end. We went ahead this way. Disc whirring away. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Stay tuned for next episode when finally I do go down to level 2 of Orlando's Wine Cellar, as I've been promising. Thanks again. Really appreciate it, guys. Hope you're enjoying the game. Still a thrill to be playing this for you guys. It's a lot of fun, and it's really... this is really an unsung classic, in my opinion, from what I can tell. So far, before what I've heard, before that, I've been wanting to play this for quite a while, and it's really not... it doesn't get the recognition it deserves, so it's basically a hidden gem among PC games. So, yeah, thanks so much. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.